The chain fountain effect, also known as the Mould effect, is this effect where you take a long chain of beads and you let it fall, kind of like this. I'm not going to show the whole thing here because if you're familiar with it, you've already seen it. I will show it again. It is a great way of getting knots in your chains, by the way. Something you want to try and play around with these. So the chain fountain is this cool effect. There have been a bunch of videos made on it. I have watched nearly all the videos on YouTube of the chain fountain just to see what people have done. I actually made a video a couple years ago showing off the chain fountain effect. It was kind of, it wasn't very unique looking back because a lot of people have made videos about it. You know, I wanted to try something unique with these chains, especially since I have so much time and I want to use these for something. I was going to try four different experiments with the chain fountain. Hopefully these have not been done on YouTube. I'm pretty confident that they haven't. If they have, I apologize, but so I recognize that that's a possibility. So first I'm going to show you a video of the regular chain fountain effect, just with one falling chain, as I call it. And I'll have some slow motion as well. And so I'll show that for you here as a sort of reference to compare the other experiments that I'm going to do. So the first thing that I haven't seen tried before, and I was very curious as to what would happen when you did it, is if you took the whole chain, you stretched it out all the way out, and then you folded it in half, and then you filled the container with those chains and let them fall. So basically you'd have two falling chains, quote unquote. There's a bee or something. That was scary. I wanted to see what would happen if you did that. So that's what I'll show here. I also forgot to mention my observation, obviously, with the first, just the normal chain fountain effect, is that it gets pretty high. I'm not going to go into the physics of it in this video, and I won't because there's other videos out there. So it gets pretty high height, but as you saw with the two chains, it doesn't go as high. My theory for that is simply that the two chains are hitting each other as they're going through the air, and because of that, they're not able to get as high. I think that's just simply what's going on. I also tried it with four falling chains. So basically fold it one more time and you get four. I'm just gonna make it look like I did it. So four falling chains at once, see what that looks like. I'll show that right here. Okay, so once again, they don't go as high, and they It empties out really fast as well. I also did it with 8 falling chains. I'm not going to try, I'm going to mess it up with the fingers. But 8 falling chains. So I'll show that right here. Okay, so that also looked really cool. That's basically the extent of my observations to this point as the sun comes out. It's very cool. It looks otherworldly and weird from above. It's just super cool looking at it, the slow motion from above. I just haven't seen that before. So, man, this is a really uncomfortable position, but I have to get through this. Oh, man. Yeah, so those were 3 experiments that I tried, and then the last one, I was always wondering, no one's tried it underwater that I've seen, to see if the chain fountain effect works underwater, so I went to try it. The thing is, to preface it, it's a little different than what I did just here, or just in the video. I didn't use this container because I had to preserve as much height as I could, because underwater, at least my theory was that you would probably need more height in order to get the chain fountain effect to actually work, since there's more friction from the water, which seemed to be the truth, as you'll see in a minute. So I had to do it on like a smaller platform with less of it, but the point of it is to prove that it works. I don't have a pool or access to a public pool because of the current global situation of pandemic. Well, that's my excuse. Anyways, I probably still wouldn't do it. But for now, I'm doing it with a bathtub because that's the best I could do. So here's that here. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna come down to my knees now because that's really unhealthy for the knees, the position I'm doing. So you can see it works underwater. I thought it was pretty cool. It was good to see it works underwater. I didn't see why it wouldn't, but I hadn't seen it underwater before, so there's that. But that's all I have for this video. If you have any comments comments for how I can make the video better, I would love to hear those. But comments on other effects you want to see, or other experiments with the mold effect that you want to see, I could try those out, especially with slow motion as well. So, but that's all I have. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna get off my knees because this is really uncomfortable.